Symbiosis Biology Teacher.
Hello children, welcome to Symbiosis AP and TS syllabus. This is my first video for class 8 children. In this video, we are going to see chapter 1, that is, what is science? Okay? Today, there is a lot of development which you are seeing in the world, like computers, mobiles, rockets, satellites, hybrid food grains, different types of clothes, right? And in your house, there are some different types of products. This is all because of the knowledge which was gained by some of the members. Okay? So it is all because of the ideas which were originated in the brains of some people. So these people, they think in a different way to understand the nature. Now the question is, what is science? Okay, let us see. To understand this, let us see the various definitions of science now. Okay, children?
So here the first definition is the concerted efforts that we make to understand the history of the natural world and its working by using observable physical evidences as basis of understanding is called science, and it is done through observation and experimentation. Science is a process of thinking. Science is an organized study of knowledge. Science is a tool for searching the truths of nature. Science is the way of exploring the world.
Okay, now you have seen various definitions of science. Now let us see questioning. What is questioning? To understand science, questioning is the primary or fundamental step. Without questioning, we cannot understand anything. We cannot understand the science. There are so many phenomena that occur in the nature. To understand that, let us take some questions which arise in our minds. So many questions get sprouted in our minds. You too might have got some questions. Okay, so let us see some questions which generally arise in our mind. Okay, children?
Right. Here are the questions. Why do leaves fall down from the tree after turning yellow? How do ants identify sweets kept in a tin? Why can't we see stars during daytime? Pickles do not spoil, but sambar gets spoiled soon. Why? Farmers are afraid of unseasonal rains and uncontrolled pests. How to solve these problems? How are diseases caused? And how to prevent and cure them?
Right. Now you have seen the different questions which have arisen in your minds. Okay. Not only these questions, but still there are some questions which have been arising in your minds. Okay, all the scientists are not working on one particular aspect. There are so many branches, there are so many fields in the science where the scientists are working. So now let us see different scientists and their studies. Okay, children?
Okay, children. First, let us see ecologist. Who is an ecologist here? ecologists, they are scientists who study about the different types of organisms in the forests, deserts, wetlands, or any other ecosystems and their interaction with each other as well as with their environment. Okay. Now, let us see about the geologists. Who are geologists? Here, geologists, they study about the earthquakes, landslides, floods, and volcanic eruptions to survey land and come up with safe building plans. They not only investigate metals and minerals, but also look for oil, natural gas, water, etc. Right, children? Now, let us see about the astrophysicist. Who is an astrophysicist? Astrophysicists, they study about the space science, that is, about the birth, life, and death of stars, planets, galaxies, nebulae, and other objects that are present in the universe. Right, children? Now, let us see climatologist. Who is a climatologist? Climatologists are the scientists who study about the climate of the earth. What they do? They collect and analyze data from ice cores, soil, water, air, and even plant life to find patterns in the weather and its effect on the earth and its inhabitants. Inhabitants means the members, the living organisms present on the earth. Right, children? Now, let us see about the chemist. Chemists, who are that chemists? Chemists are the scientists who study about the different chemicals and their uses to improve the way of our living. They develop products such as synthetic fibers, drugs, and cosmetics. They even make processes like oil refining and petrochemical processing that reduce pollution. Right, children? Now let us see physicist. Who is a physicist? Physicists are scientists who study about the physical phenomena. They even devise hypotheses, conduct experiments, and draw conclusions from experimental data to explain the world around us. Okay, children? Now, let us see biologist. Who is biologist here? Biologists are scientists who study about the organisms and plant life to learn more about their composition, behaviors, habitats, and how they interact with other organisms and their environment. They even study about the cause of a disease and its prevention also. Right, children? Now let us categorize these scientists into two. That is, these scientists, they are broadly classified into two types. Scientists who are under the observational science and the scientists who are under the experimental science. For example, here you can see ecologist, geologist, astrophysicist, and climatologist. These type of scientists, they are mainly based on observation. So what is their main role here? Observation. In the same way, chemist, physicist, biologist, these three types of scientists, their main role is to experiment. If they want to find out anything, what they do? They do experiments. And one more thing, children, you can see here, each scientist is studying about something. So what is that study? Here you can see ecologist, his study or her study is called as ecology. In the same way, geologist's study is geology. Astrophysicist study is astrophysics. Climatologist study is climatology. And coming to chemist, his study is chemistry. In the same way, physicist, his study is physics. And biologist, his study is biology. Right, children? Okay.
So, the main goal of these scientists is to show that old ideas are wrong and they come up with new ideas, okay, new inventions or new discoveries. Whatever they have come to know before, that they will update. Okay, children? Now, this is all they are doing to understand the nature in a better way. Okay, now let us see the word science. This word science has come from Latin word. So this Latin word for science is scientia. The Latin word for science is scientia. The science word has come from this word called as scientia. And the meaning of this word scientia is knowledge. It is knowledge. Okay, children? Right. For more videos, please subscribe to my channel and click on the bell icon for notifications. And if you really like my videos, then please give likes, comments, and definitely share these videos to others. Thank you very much.